सदस्यों का इस दिशा में कोई विशेष सुझाव है तो मैं उसको पूरा विचार करूंगा।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 304 मोहम्मद फैजल जी।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 304 मैडम।
स्टेटमेंट इज लेड ऑन द टेबल ऑफ द हाउस।
पूछिए
मैडम। बिफोर मी गोइंग इनटू द क्वेश्चन आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सटेंड माय सिंसियर थैंक्स टू द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर on behalf of entire students of Lakshadweep, especially Lakshadweep Students Association, for enhancing their scholarship which was pending for quite 6 years.
Yes.
And thank you for you madam also, you given me an opportunity to raise that issue in a zero over the last previous session.
Yes.
I'm very happy to see the answer of the honorable minister.
Yes.
And my specific question to the minister is that whether government of India is planning to start employment and skill oriented institution in my constituency Lakshadweep, and if so what are the modalities of recruiting the trainers? Why I ask this question specifically is that Lakshadweep is going through a very tough situation, seeing that during 2008 madam,
yeah,
all these schools, which is all government schools there madam, honorable ministers knows that also, I have taken that matter to the minister. During 2008, all the schools of Lakshadweep were upgraded to plus two. But from 2008 to till date, the teachers are appointed on contract basis, on yearly basis. The inherent problem of this contract appointment is that every year, the student have to face new teachers. Which one teacher is different from, just give me madam 1 minute because I am the only MP from Lakshadweep. There is no MLA, no chief minister. I have to raise the issue before, and you have given me ample opportunity that also.
I am giving you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
I know. Yes.
So thank you very much, ma'am. So my I met with the honorable prime minister also a day before yesterday.
Yes.
I was requesting him for his kind intervention. That is, there is a proposal from 2011 onwards in the ministry of HRD for creating 120 posts of postgraduate teachers, which will definitely improve the education of Lakshadweep, because now the graph when we take, the quality of education has gone down because of the scientific recruitment method of contract teachers. So my specific question is that, okay, since I elucidated that some problem with my constituency, my question with the honorable minister is that whether such skill-oriented institutions are being planned to start in my constituency, and whether, what are the methodology,
yes,
for the recruitment?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, it seems today is a day of thanksgiving for the ministry because of the honorable member's question, especially part C. I was quite intrigued when the member posed a question asking specifically about the Indian Centre for Research and Development of Community Education. Though the UGC had absolutely no information about this so-called centre, when I took a morning meeting as to what is this centre all about, because an honourable member of this house has asked a pertinent question with regards to a pertinent organisation, we within the ministry went hunting on open courseware on the internet and found that this particular institution claims to be the coordinating agency of all community colleges in India, which is a false claim. I would like to thank the honorable member for asking this part of the question, because it enables us now to investigate as to why such a private institution, which is not within the realm of the UGC or the AICT, is making such a claim, thereby raising many a question. So I thank him for that. I would also, acknowledge here on the floor of the House that the member has appealed to me on many an issue with regards to the state of education in Lakshadweep. And I have extended all the support that I can through the Ministry of HRD so that all solutions can be found. But rationalization of teachers is an issue which cannot be done centrally. Ever since I have received the responsibility under the leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister for human resource development in the country, I have personally appealed to every state, written to them, spoken to them, and in dialogues with state education ministers, even requested with administrators within that union territories also requested for rationalization of teachers, because we provide for permanent faculty to be there. Insofar as skilling, I think my senior colleague Mr. Rudy has spoken about his desire and his initiative to set up a skilling component and initiative in every district, in every Lok Sabha constituency, and I'm sure that his initiative will take care of a lot of your needs. Apart from that, there is something which we have launched under the UGC, which is called the Deen Dayal Upadhyay Kaushal Kendra. In the 12th plan, we plan to set up 100 such centers. The guidelines for this was notified in December 2014. It has been available on the website of the UGC, so that any institution which is NAC grade A can apply for this, along with an NGO or philanthropic foundation, and open up a skilling center. I invite any applications that the Honorable Member deems fit through the UGC, so that people in Lakshadweep can be more empowered. I would also like to say that the UGC is going to give a grant of 5 crores for this and allow adjunct faculty, which means that industry experts can be allowed into these skilling centers, so that our young are trained and made employable.
Second supplementary opinion.
Thank you very much, Minister, for such an elaborate answer. And my subsidiary question, second question is that, madam, across India, as far as Lakshadweep is concerned, madam, it is coming directly under you. That's why the specific question is coming. Madam, all whatever the recruitment, whatever the methodology taken there is adopted there with the concurrence of the concerned ministry. So that's why this specific question comes. Again, my request, my sincere request to you is that please, please sanction those 120 post for postgraduate is pending with that, because that is the final solution one. Till such time, the contract appointment which is given in the island, the methodology which I elucidated earlier also. Now the issue is that the prime concern is to select a good teacher rather than giving an employment for X or Y. So the methodology which is adopted there is based, given advantage for the person who is giving marks more in the academic session rather than finding out whether he have an ability to teach the student in the better way. So my specific question is that, madam, whether the government from your ministry, which I think I have given a letter to you in that regard, that keep all the qualified hands, teachers, to in the same platform, let them compete each other, show their caliber, to take from them the best teacher, that is what
please,
we wanted. Is there any move from the ministry to streamline the contract appointment of teachers in Lakshadweep?
Madam Speaker, though the question pertains to skill-oriented courses, I acknowledge the concern expressed by the Honourable Member. Yes. I would also like to say that yes, skilling up and scaling up our teaching faculties is also a concern which is shared by everybody in this House and across the nation. Under the leadership of the Honourable Prime Minister, Madam Speaker, on the 25th of December 2014, he launched the Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teachers Training. Apart from that, the NCTE guidelines, which were notified last year, 2014, under the instructions of the MHRD, insisted that teachers, when they are trained, should spend 20 weeks in a classroom teaching, so that they can be analyzed for their skills, and their skills after analyzation can be supplemented with any other support that is needed, so that we have better skilled teachers. But I would also like to tell the member that apart from the teachers skilling program or training program that we have initiated, we are also taking care that teachers within the system currently in conjunction with the states are given in-service training also.
Sri Harish Meena ji.